In the previous video, we looked at how we can export bibliographic data from EndNote 20 ready for import into NVivo. In this video, we'll cover the import part of the process. Before I begin, I'm going to create some subfolders ready for my literature. So to start off with, underneath Data, I click on Files and right-click to choose New Folder. I'm going to call this Literature, and then click OK. I'm also going to repeat this process under Externals by right-clicking, choosing New Folder, and calling it Literature. We've not looked at externals before, but as you can see here, externals are proxy documents created in NVivo to represent data sources that cannot be imported. This will be used for any record in EndNote that lacked a PDF file. Now that we've created these two subfolders, we're ready to import. On the Import ribbon, I choose Bibliography, and then from the drop-down list, choose EndNote. Next, I need to browse to the file. So I'm going to go to my desktop, and then my data, to find the file I just created in the previous video. After clicking on this XML file, I can choose Open, and the Import from EndNote dialog will open. You can see, first of all, it confirms the import from path. I then have a choice as how to name these new files. I can choose title or author and year. I'm going to leave this at title. I then have an option as to how I assign the classifications. The PDFs will be brought in as different files and then classified. I can either have this under a single classification type, reference, or a different classification based on record types, such as journal, book, or website. To allow better comparability, I'm going to leave this at a single classification. Next, we can see NVivo is scanning my existing library, and it can see that of the 23 records in this import, none of them already exist in my library. So, they're all greyed out. But this is really useful if I were to re-import files at a later date. This way, I don't need to dig through my EndNote library to just bring in new files. I can export the whole set of records again, and NVivo will automatically detect duplicates and not bring them in again. Finally, when it comes down to the Importing New Records area, we can choose the Select option here to specify those new literature folders we created under both Files and Externals. I'm going to leave the rest of these options at their default to create memos based on the abstracts and assign attribute values to memos. And also we want to import file content from file attachments, URLs, figures, and so on. As soon as we click Import, you can see NVivo is busy creating those files, and progress is shown at the bottom left of the screen. As soon as all those new files are created, it then classifies them. If I head to my literature folder under files, I can see all of those journal articles are brought in. I can see in the literature folder under externals that any missing PDF is represented by an external here. This means I can double click on any of these items and manually type any of my thoughts or even abstracts from those sources into here, allowing me to account for them in my analysis in NVivo. If I return to the literature folder under files, I can further see some of the metadata brought in. If I right click on any of my files and choose PDF properties, and then attribute values, we can see NVivo has brought in all that bibliographic information, such as the reference type, the author, the year, and the title. I am able to query on all of these aspects later in my analysis. You'll notice that many of these files have this little link icon to indicate there is a linked memo. If I right click on any of them, I can choose Memo Link and then Open Linked Memo. You'll see this is the article abstract. If you remember, when we imported the file, it gave us the option to import abstracts from EndNote and store them as memos. For this reason, if you open the Notes folder and then Memos, you'll see there's lots of additional memos down here, all of them representing abstracts from the imported articles. These are classed as a separate data source to the articles themselves. And NVivo has automatically linked all of them in here. This completes the import from EndNote. Look at the next few videos in this series for further advice on how to analyse and query literature in NVivo.